Good evening. We invite you to watch the English News, our essential television channel of the Malaya Province. I myself, a delegation of Provincial Party Committee, People's Council, People's Committee, and the Vietnam Falun Front Committee of the Malaya Province, led by Mr. Wang Minh-Cư, Deputy Secretary of Provincial Party Committee and Head of Provincial National Assembly Delegation, visited and presented gifts to Điện Biên soldiers, youth volunteers, and frontline porters who directly participated in the Điện Biên Phủ campaign in Xuân Lộc District. The delegation visited the foreign veterans, Phan Thanh Sợi, born in 1925, residing in Ward 3, Gia Rai Town, Đinh Thái Báo, born in 1930, residing in Gia Hòa, Hamlet, Xuân Trường, Camu, and Lê Văn Thuong, born in 1931, residing in Gia Rai, Hamlet, Suối Cao, Camu, Xuân Lộc District. At each place the delegation visited on behalf of Provincial Party Committee, People's Council, People's Committee, and Vietnam Falun Front Committee of the Malaya Province, Mr. Wang Minh-Cư, Deputy Secretary of Provincial Party Committee and Head of the Malaya Provincial National Assembly Delegation, inquired about the health of Điện Biên soldiers. He expressed his deep gratitude for the immense contributions and sacrifice of heroic martyrs, Điện Biên soldiers, youth volunteers, and frontline porters who directly participated in a resistance war against the French, contributing to the historic Điện Biên Phủ victory. Deputy Secretary of Provincial Party Committee Wang Minh-Cư particularly emphasized that the local authorities and party committees should continue to pay attention to and care for and well implement the policies and regimes of the party and state for those with meritorious services, including the Điện Biên soldiers who directly fought and served in the Điện Biên Phủ campaign. After a continuous decline for a year, in the late half of April and early May, many banks began to adjust and increase saving interest rates for both short and long terms. The highest common saving interest rate on the market currently fluctuates above 6% per year for a term of 24 to 36 months. Saving interest rates at banks have increased again in the context of people's deposits gradually being withdrawn from the banking system. Specifically, according to statistics from State Bank of Vietnam, deposits of economic organizations at the end of January this year were more than 6.7 million trillion dong, down more than 165,000 billion dong compared to the end of 2023, equivalent to a decrease of 2.41%. Meanwhile, people's deposits also decreased by more than 34,600 billion dong in January to nearly 6.5 million trillion dong. Notably, this is the first month that people's deposits have turned around and decreased. After having grown positively for 25 consecutive months before that, the Standing Committee of the North Provincial Party Committee had just requested party committees, party organization authorities, and Falun Front and social political organizations at all levels in the province to organize further and intensive propaganda to raise awareness among cadres, party members, and people about the viewpoints, goals, principles, and roadmap for arranging commune-level administrative units in the Malaya province in the period of 2023-2025. Clearly identified the implementation of commune-level administrative unit arrangement as a key political task throughout the period 2023-2025 and implemented it in accordance with the Plan No. 1, dated November 2, 2023, a Provincial People's Committee that has been appraised and approved by the competent authority. The Party Committee of Provincial People's Committee shall lead and direct departments, branches, localities to develop plans and broad maps for the arrangement of organization apparatus and the placement of surplus cadres, civil servants, officers, and employees in the communes and wards after rearrangement. In addition, the plan for handling receipts, handover and use of office premises, assets, facilities, and funding sources, and etc., must ensure visibility, efficiency, and compliance with regulations. Chinese President Xi Jinping, French President Emmanuel Macron, and European Commission President Ursula von der Leyen had a trilateral meeting at the Elysee Palace in Paris on May 5th. The meeting is within the framework of a Chinese leader visit to three European countries, with France being the first stop. At the beginning of the meeting, President Macron said that France never wanted to separate from China and emphasized the need to make efforts to prevent a trade war between Europe and Beijing, including the possibility of imposing tariffs on China imports. According to French President, Beijing cooperation also plays a decisive role in major crises, including Ukraine. He called on China to coordinate closely with Europe to resolve this conflict. A response, Mr. Xi said China has always approached its relationship with the European Union from a strategic and long-term perspective and views Europe as an important partner on the path toward modernization. He hopes that China-France and China-Europe relations will strengthen each other and develop together. Previously, European Commission President Ursula von der Leyen vowed to promote fair competition with Europe. She stated, "The European Union and China want to have good relations. Cooperation between us is key to ensuring mutual respect, avoiding misunderstandings, and finding common solutions to global challenges. This is especially important as we approach the 50th anniversary of Europe-China relations next year." Yesterday, the Palestinian Hamas movement agreed to a ceasefire proposal in the Gaza Strip with Qatari and Egyptian mediators. However, Israel objected, saying that Hamas do remain far from meeting Israel demands.
Hamas announced this agreement to a ceasefire in three phases. Each phase lasts for 42 days. The first phase is hostage-prisoner exchange. The second phase that Israel completely withdraws its troops and displaced Palestinians return to Gaza. And the final stage is to implement the Gaza reconstruction plan. Hamas not warmly welcomed by Palestinians to have a separation.
"I can't describe to you how happy I am. Honestly, I can't believe it. The joy is unbelievable, but that joy was quickly extinguished. Israel has rejected the condition of a complete ceasefire with Hamas and announced that it will continue to attack the city of Rafah. Palestinians were devastated by the news, while Israelis criticized the government for ruining the deal."
You have just finished watching the English News on Essential Television Channel of Nomad Province. Thanks for watching and goodbye.